Hello students, today we are going to deal with the volume of cuboid. So this is given in the exercise 13.5 of chapter surface areas and volume of NCERT of class 9. So as example, I have taken question number 6, that is also a very important question and slightly different also, that will cover your other knowledge also, as well as the volume of the cuboid. So the question is, a village having a population of 4000 requires 150 liters of water per head per day. It has a tank measuring 20 meter into 15 meter into 6 meter. For how many days will the water of this tank will last? So the question is that in a village, one person need for one day at least 150 liters. Yes, and the population of the village is 4000. So, and the tank in the village is of this dimensional. These are the dimensions that are given to us. Yes, and we have to find out in this, the dimension that is given of the tank, in a tank, how much water is there that will last, that will be for how many days. Yes, it will be for the village. So first of all, we need to find out, as we can see, first of all, let's draw a figure for this. Suppose this is a tank. Yes. Now, 20 meter is the length, 15 meter wide, and the 6 meter is the height. Yes. Now the water is inside the tank. So we first of all, we will find out the volume of the tank, means the capacity of the tank, how much water will be here in this tank. Now the according to the information given to us, that is for one person, 150 liter water is required, and for the 4000, 150 into 4000, that will equal to, just multiply 1 2 3 4 by 4 is 22, 4 into 4 5 6, so we can say 6 lakh liters water is required for the village population for one day. Yes, so it is required for the one day. Now we have to find out how much the, what is the capacity of the that tank. So volume of tank, here we represent the volume of the tank, is equal to L into B into H. This is the formula for the volume of the cuboid. Yes, and the tank is of the cuboid shape. Yes, now let's put the value. So 20 into breadth, it is already given, 15 into h, that is 6. So we will get, after multiplying, we will get 1800 meter. Yes, 6 to the 12 15, so yes, so 1800 meters we have got the capacity of the tank. Yes, now this is given in the meter cube. We need to convert this meter cube into the liters. Yes, so we know that 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liters, that we have to remember. Yes, 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liter. So what we will do, we will put, instead of 1 meter cube, we will put the value of in liters, and we can get in the liters. So that will be 1800 multiplied by 1000, that is equal to 18 lakh actually. Yes, so now we have got the capacity of the tank, that is the 18,000. Yes, now for one day it is required at least 6 lakh liters. Yes, and the capacity of the tank is 18 lakh. So for how many days it will last? If we use the unitary method, that is for the one day, 6 lakh is for the one day, so 1 liter is for the this one day we will use this unitary method here. So what we will do, we will divide this 18 lakh by 6 lakh and we can get how many days this water will be last. Yeah, for how many days it will be the village population can use this. So number of days is equal to 18 lakh upon 6 lakh and that is equal to 3 days. Yes, so I think it is clear and that is very important question also. Yes, because here the water and the population, three things are used, the application of the application of the formula of the that cuboid also for the volume. And see, we just revise the question. See, here the tank is given to us and first and it is the information given that the 150 liters is required for the one person and the population is 4000. So first of all we will find out the for the complete population. So we got that by here we are using the unitary method. Yes, so for one person 150 liter and for 4000 that will be when we multiply that we got 6 lakh liters are required for one day. Yes, for the complete village. Yes, now volume of the tank is, the capacity of the tank is 1800 meter cube. Now 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liters, so we need to convert this in meter cube into the liters. So we have just used this information and we multiply and we have converted this meter cube into the liters. Yes, now we have to find out the for how many days. So whenever this type of situation is there, because this is the for the one day and this is the complete capacity, so when we divide this 18 lakh by 6 lakh we can get the number of days. Now let me tell you why we are dividing, because we are again using here the unitary method. Since 6 lakh is for the one day, so 1 liter is for the 1 upon 6 lakh and then for the 18 lakh water will be, that is, that should be multiplied. Yes, so it is 1 upon 6 lakh into 18 lakh and we have got this, that is the 3 days. So this is the number of days that the water will be last for the village. Now I hope this question is clear to you. Now proceed to the next question. Again, this is of the exercise 13.5 and the question number is 9. A river 3 meter deep and the 40 meter wide is flowing at the rate of 2 kilometer is per hour. How much water will be fall into the sea in a minute? So first of all, let's draw a figure for us. That is, suppose this is the river. For 1 hour we are making, that is 3 meter deep, means this is 3 meter, the height is 3 meter, and 40 meter wide. So this is how much wide it is, that is 40 meter. A river 3 meter deep and 40 meter wide is flowing at the rate of 2 kilometer per hour. So when the water is flowing, yes, that is 2 kilometer per hour. Yes, now water is coming like this. Yes, of course here is also a river, here is also a river. We have just taken this to understand this. Yes, a part. So water is flowing 2 km per hour. So the whenever the speed is given, so we just like 2 km we will take as a length. Now because since that this is also given in the meters, this is also given in the meter, that is the breadth as well as the height is given in the meters, so we will convert this 2000 meter per hour. Yes, so the water is flowing 2000 meter per hour as 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. Yes, now first of all we will find out the capacity of this water of this river in 1 hour. Yes, so in 1 hour, see again it is of the shape of the cuboid. Yes, So the capacity will be, that is L, that is the length, that is the 2000. 2000 water aya in 1 hour, width is 40 and the height is 3. Yes, so we have got 4, 3 is 12, 12, 2 is 24 to 40,000 meter cube. Yes, so this is that we have find out the capacity in 1 hour of the river. In 1 hour, how much water is flowing? Now in 1 hour means it is in the 60 minutes. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So see how easy this question is. How much water will fall into the sea in a minute? We simply want, as we have find out for the 60 minutes, this meter cube, this 40,000 water meter cube is flowing in a 60 minutes. So 1 minute, 24 upon 60, that will be cancelled out. 64, the that is equal to 4000 meter cube water in 1 minute that will fall into the sea. Yes, clear? Thank you.